Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about linear inequalities again, our third video on representing them as graph regions. Let's start with something I need you to know and from previous skills. I would like you to identify the region R satisfied by the following inequality. We've done this in video 2 on this topic. Pause, have a go. Well, in order to do that, I would have expected you to do the following. Draw the line y equals 2x subtract 3, using the fact that we've got a gradient of 2 and a y-intercept of negative 3. You would draw the line dotted, as it is a strict inequality. You want the points, the y-points, that are bigger than 2x subtract 3. On the line, y is equal to 2x subtract 3. So you want above that line, so you're going to shade below that line and label above the line r, as told in the question. And finally, you test some point in the region you labelled R just to make sure it satisfies the equation or the inequality to give you some comfort that you've done it correctly. Now, when we did that skill, maybe it felt a bit weird to shade what you're not interested in. That now is going to become crucial to us when we combine lots of inequalities in the region at the same time. So let's go straight into an example where we're asked to identify a region satisfied by several inequalities. Here we go. Now, if you feel like you can do this, pause the video and have a go. Otherwise, I'll go through in a few seconds. Okay, we've got three inequalities on the go, so we need to draw ourselves three lines. Let's do that one by one. Let's firstly draw ourselves this line here. Now, the way I do it with things like this, I imagine x to be 0. If x was 0, y would be equal to 5. If I'm trying to draw the line x add y equals 5, and the other way around, if y was equal to 0, if I imagine y being 0, x would be 5. So I know the line x add y equals 5 goes through the pairs of coordinates 0, 5 and 5, 0. So that helps me draw this one super fast, so I can label that point there. I can label that point there. And I'm going to draw myself a filled in line because it's less than or equal to. So I'm going to draw myself a line something like that. And I'm going to label that up there as the line x add y is equal to 5. Now I'm going to worry about shading the region and labeling r at the very end when I've drawn all lines. Now from here I'm going to draw the line x is equal to 1. Right? So let's draw that line x is equal to 1. We're going to draw it with a dotted line here because it's a strict inequality. So let me just do that here. Line x equals 1 will go something like this, and let's label that up as the line x equals 1, right? And we also want to draw the line y is equal to negative 2, so let's draw that, and we need to use a dotted line as well. So let's make sure we use a dotted line because it's a strict inequality. So at y is negative 2, let's draw ourselves a line across there and label that there y is equal to negative 2. Okay, now let's try and identify the region R that's satisfied simultaneously by all three inequalities. Now it's going to be really helpful here to shade what you don't want. If we were to shade everything we wanted, we'd end up with a cluttered picture. If you shade what you don't want, the thing that's unshaded left in the picture is always your region R. So let's do this one by one. X add y is less than or equal to 5. That line there is x add y equals 5. We want the x and y's that add up to less than or equal to 5. So we want below the line, so let's shade above the line to identify we don't want any of that stuff there. Okay? Let's do the next one. We want the x's that are strictly bigger than 1. So we don't want any x's less than or equal to 1. So anything this side of the line here up to the line x equal 1, we don't want them at all like that. And lastly, we want the y's bigger than negative 2. This line here is the line where y equals negative 2, so we don't want anything where y is smaller than negative 2, so we're going to highlight those there. And this is where shading what you don't want really works nicely for you. You get yourself the unshaded region left over is clearly R, nicely labelled like that. And we better test a point, hadn't we? Let's test some point in there. There's a point 2, 2 here. Let's test 2, 2 satisfies all the inequalities. Okay. So for this one here, Is 2 add 2 less than or equal to 5? Absolutely, it is. Is 2 bigger than 1? Absolutely. Is 2 for y bigger than negative 2? Absolutely. That point satisfies all three inequalities, and it makes us feel confident that we've labelled the correct region R. And that's how you do these. Let's give one more a go for you. Pause the video and try this one yourself. Okay, step one is to draw the following lines. We're going to draw the line y equals x add 3. We're going to draw the line y equals 2x. We're going to draw the line x equals 0. And then we're going to worry about whether they're filled in lines and dotted lines, and then the regions, etc. Right, this first one here. This has a gradient of 1 and it has a y-intercept of 0, 3. So we know that if we go here to 0, 3, and as I go to the right one, I go up one. As I go to the right one, I go up one, etc. As I go down one, I go left one. And go down one, I go left one. We're quickly getting ourselves our set of coordinates there. And it would look something like this here. Okay, and let's label in. Let's make sure whatever we do, we label in that there as the line y is equal to x add 3. Done the first one. Now, we want for ourselves a filled in line here because it's less than or equal to. That's why I've left it filled in. This one here, draw the line y equals 2x. Well, that has a gradient of 2 and it has a y-intercept of 0, 0. So it goes through here. As you go to the right one, you go up 2. Go to the right one, you go up 2. As you go to the right one, you go up 2. As you go to the left one, you go down 2. Left one, down 2. You get in the picture there. And we can draw that line in here, no problem at all. And what we do, like that, and we'd label that one up as well, so make sure we label that one, and this is the line here, y is equal to 2x. Now, we want y strictly bigger than 2x, so we must draw a dotted line. You must remember to make that a dotted line, else you might lose some marks. Okay, so that's a dotted line there. And lastly, we want what x is strictly bigger than 0. So let's draw the line x equals 0, which will be this line here. Okay, and we'll label it x equals 0. We want to make that a dotted line because we want x strictly bigger than 0. So we'll make that a dotted line for ourselves here. And there you go. You've got your three lines drawn on the graph. Now, let's just think about shading. Maybe let's start here. This line here is all the y numbers that are equal to x add 3. We want the y numbers less than x add 3. We want below this line. We're going to shade above this line to identify that we don't want anything above that line there. Okay? This one here, we want all the y numbers bigger than 2x. This is the line y equals 2x. We want the numbers where y is bigger than that, we want above the line, so we're going to shade ourselves below the line here to say we don't want any of that. And we want all the x numbers bigger than 0, so we don't want any of the x numbers smaller than 0, so we're going to shade all of this to say we don't want any of that either. And we're left with, as clear as day, something unshaded here, this triangle here, which we'll call R. Now, let's test a point to double check we haven't made a mistake. That point there, 1, 3, x is 1 and y is 3, is in the region. Let's check it works for all the inequalities. Is it true that 3 is less than or equal to 1 add 3? It is. 3 is less than or equal to 4. Is it true that 3 is bigger than 2 multiplied by 1? Absolutely, 3 is bigger than 2. Is it true that at this point here, 1 for x is bigger than 0? Absolutely, it's true. And we've identified the correct region there, and we've checked a point in our region and made ourselves feel confident we've got the right answer. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks loads for watching.